Hello guys, this is Ravens from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 83.
Graduate from IIT Kharagpur, Kishore Indukuri, who originally hails from Karnataka, went to pursue his master degree and PhD from the University of Massachusetts and worked at Intel for 6 years before returning to India and starting his own dairy in the year 2012 with an investment of just 20 cows. By 2018, Indukuri's dairy farm named Sid's Farm after his son Siddharth was delivering milk to 6,000 customers in and around Hyderabad. Today, Sid's Farm, located in Shahabad, has expanded its operation to include 120 employees and has achieved an annual revenue of Rs. 40 crore. It delivers milk to nearly 10,000 customers every day. The annual Display Week conference tipped off yesterday in San Jose, California, and Samsung Display is one of the most active participants. The Korean tech giant is showcasing its new wave of foldable OLED developments, and now we got another in-depth look at the devices in a promo video. The first device is a video featuring a S-Fold display and bends at 2 points. When fully extended, the display measures up to 7.2 inch, giving users a larger canvas for multitasking. We get another look at Samsung's new laptop display with an under-panel camera which represents a whole new take on ultrabook panel with some of the slimmest bezels you will see on any mobile display. The 17-inch foldable laptop looks inspired by Microsoft Surface Neo, is showcased as a capable productivity machine in a sleek and compact form factor with a versatile hinge mechanism. The upcoming Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 will be heavily revamped version of previous model and runs on new operating system. There have been suggestions and hints that have been overall on the Galaxy Watch series will be carried out this year. Pro Samsung tech blog Sam Mobile has now released an exclusive report which it claims to confirm that the Korean tech giant would be ditching the Tizen OS in favor of the Android Wear OS for the upcoming Galaxy Watch 4 models. Hence, for the 2021 lineup, Samsung watches will be running on the Wear OS only. Next generation Pixel smartphone may have under-display cameras thanks to a new Google patent. Under-display camera technology is currently emerging as a replacement for punch-hole cameras in the smartphone displays. A blog has discovered a new Google patent for its take on this new kind of selfie camera, thereby strongly hinting that the potential upgrade is destined for the Pixel 7 or later. Reliance Jio announced that it is constructing the largest international submarine cable system centered on India. Jio, along with several key global partners and submarine cable supplier Subcom, is currently deploying the two next generation cables to support the extraordinary growth in India demand across the region. These high capacity and high speed systems will provide more than 200 TBs of capacity spanning over 16,000 kilometers. Employing open system technology and the latest wavelength switched road ramp branching units ensure rapid upgrade development and the ultimate flexibility to add drop waves across multiple locations. The DOT is likely to ask TRAI to suggest new reserve pieces of all spectrum bands which are cleared at the 5G trials. Besides, it is expected that these spectrum bands might be included in the next spectrum sale, which is likely to be conducted in the first half of 2022. And Xiaomi has just shared that it has led the smartphone market in 12 different countries across the globe. Now the company has also arrived number 1 in terms of after-sales services in India. Xiaomi has just announced that the brand has managed to lead the smartphone market in 12 different nations across the globe in the first quarter of this year. This news was shared earlier today on Weibo, a Chinese microblogging website. Xiaomi recently launched a smoke detector manufactured in conjunction with Honeywell. The Chinese tech giant has now announced a similar product dubbed Xiaomi Honeywell Gas Leak Detector. The product will be available under crowdfunding from May 19th. Just as the name implies, Xiaomi Honeywell Gas Leak Detector is designed to monitor natural gas leaks in real time. The device is integrated with a high decibel alarm that will be triggered when the gas leak is detected. The leak detector can also be linked to close the solenoid valve. Apart from the gas leak detection feature, the Xiaomi gas detector is integrated with Bluetooth gateway, bringing on board Xiaomi's all IoT smart experience. In terms of the design, it uses dual front and rear air inlets and built-in sensors. When the natural gas concentration reaches the alarm set wall, the device will immediately send out an audible and visual alarm signal. The alarm sound is at least 70 decibel. Xiaomi and Poco phones receive 2 months of extended warranty. Oppo has extended warranty for all products till June 31, 2021. Vivo is providing 1 month of extra warranty for the day service center goes up in lockdown hit areas. Xiaomi Mi CC10 is set to ship with Qualcomm Snapdragon 870 chipset. This handset will arrive as a successor to the Mi CC9 lineup from 2021. Mi CC10 series could have multiple variants. tech giant Amazon could become the new hire of Ionic US movie studio MGM. As per the reports, the company is in talks to seal a deal for about $9 billion, that is roughly around 65,770 crores. The status of the deal is not clear at this moment. It's been reported that many companies apart from Amazon has been trying to acquire the popular US studio. Amazon Music HD is now available to all Amazon Music Unlimited users. Amazon has discounted its Music HD streaming service to as low as $8.08 for Prime members and $10.10 for non-Prime users. Amazon Music Unlimited subscribers will get the added HD streaming capabilities free of charge. The move is an obvious jab at Apple Music's new high-quality lossless audio support coming later this month. Apple has introduced spatial audio with support for Dolby Atmos on Apple Music. The company was rumored to unveil a new hi-fi tier on its music service. Apple claims that the new spatial audio features give artists the opportunity to create immersive audio experience with a true multi-dimensional sound and clarity. Customers who have subscribed to Apple Music service can listen to more than 75 million songs in lossless audio. Interestingly, Apple is not charging anything extra for the lossless audio quality. Subscribers can take advantage of the new feature at no additional cost. Apple typically offers the highest level of product quality in the industry. Customers who use Apple certified product do not tend to complain about the durability. However, there seems to be a rare case where Apple Pods have been exploded. A user claimed that the Apple AirPods exploded when they charged it by an Apple's own USB case. The user also attached images of the exploded truly wireless earbuds. He claims to have a good side burn on the hand. The users have contacted Apple after experiencing the unfortunate incident. Google I/O kicks off today, and one of the biggest announcements expected to be made is Android 12. Following the announcement, we expected partner phone companies to disclose compatible devices that can be controlled in the Android beta program. Realme has been one of the companies that has been a part of the beta program since 2019, and this year there is no different. And there is a received information from Realme that its flagship phone, the Realme GT, will be the part of Android 12 developer preview program. The beta update will be available to users in China after Google announced it later today. Realme announced the Narzo 30A and Narzo 30 Pro 5G in February. After a week of the teasing, the company today added the Vanilla 30 to the lineup. The Realme Narzo 30 is built around a 6.5 inch Full HD Plus screen with a 90Hz refresh rate and a peak brightness of 580 nits. It also has a punch hole in the upper left corner for the selfie camera, which uses a 16 megapixel Sony IMX471 sensor. Right on schedule, Honor unveiled its latest mid-range phone in China called Play 5. This phone is powered by MediaTek Dimensity 800U chipset and supports speedy 66W wired charging. The rest of the key specifications include a 6.53 inch OLED display with Full HD Plus resolution and a 16 megapixel selfie camera housed in the water drop notch. Lenovo launches its latest flagship gaming smartphone in the Chinese market called as Lenovo Legion Phone 2 Pro. The top-end variant of the device comes packed with up to 18GB of RAM and a 512GB of internal storage. Now the company has announced that 18GB RAM variant of the smartphone will be available for purchase in China from 20th May. As for the pricing, the device costs you around 5,999 yuan, which is roughly converted to $933. Li TV Super Phone teaser to launch in China soon. This handset will come with a narrow bezels and a curved edges. However, it is not clear whether Lico will be re-entering the Indian market again. Roborock has recently applied for a new trademark. The application is for a Rock Smart Car, which is for an international classification in the means of transportation. This trademark is still under the status of application for registration and has yet to be granted. A common trend among some Chinese manufacturers, especially those with multiple brands, is the rebranding of phones. Companies such as Xiaomi are known to launch same phone under different names in different markets. Now ZTE is joining the trend with its upcoming Nubia Z30 Pro, which is practically a rebacked Axon 30 Ultra. Qualcomm has announced a new chip called the Snapdragon 778G processor. The 6nm chipset is a new variant of more powerful Snapdragon 780G chipset, which was announced in March. According to the well-known tipster from China, Honor 50 will be the first phone to feature the Snapdragon 778G 5G mobile platform. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.